Good morning, my dear students. Today we are starting our course on numerical analysis, and the course code is MA 2305, numerical analysis. So, have you seen the syllabus of this numerical analysis course? If you see there, we have various topics, namely root finding, then integration, interpolation, linear system of equations, eigenvalue problem, differential equation. So, if you see the syllabus, more or less these are there, little bit more are there, that we will go in subsequent lectures. So, see these topics: root finding, integration, interpolation, linear system of equations, eigenvalue problems, differential equations. These all you have heard these topics or not? You know how to find the root. If I give you a problem x square minus 3x plus 2 is equal to 0, this you can find very easily. Okay? Integration also, if I give to find sin x dx, that also you know. Or if x sin x dx, that also you know. Interpolation, again if I have some data and corresponding to some input data I want the output, that I can find. Linear system of equation, that also you have read as Ax equal to b. How to find x? A is the matrix, b is the right hand side vector. Then eigenvalue problem, Ax is equal to lambda x. Differential equation, suppose I have dy by dx is equal to y, subject to some condition. So, my aim is, see that these all you know, okay? Then why we need again these to study? What is there and how we do? So, first of all, why we need this, what is this and how we do? Why means why we need this numerical analysis course? Because you have seen we have only those topics that you know: root finding, linear system of equations, eigenvalue problem, differential equation. But for root finding, I have given an example, that is x square minus 3x plus 2 equal to 0, that is to second degree or a quadratic equation. We have different formula, depending upon the nature of the root, you can find the solutions. But if I give you a problem, x to the power 100, minus 3x to the power 90 plus 500 sin x plus e to the power 100x is equal to 0. Okay? So, this is a simple equation, not simple, this is an equation in x. So, in general, I do not have any formula, analytical formula or known formula, so that I can find the solution of this x. Okay? But in this course, after doing this course, I can find at least one or two roots or maybe all roots, depending upon the problem. I can have the roots of this equation by different methods that we are going to discuss. Okay? Understood? But I cannot solve by any known analytical methods. Okay? Second, I told integration. Suppose I have a to b, some sin x dx, x sin x dx, simple functions you can find. Suppose I have x into sin x into sin hyperbolic x into e to the power root x by log of 1 plus x square into cos a cake x into log x u into so dx. Again, I cannot, may not find the solution of this integration very easily by any analytical methods. But using numerical methods, I can find the solution approximately. Okay? Similarly, system of equations, that is Ax is equal to b. There you have, you know that if A by A is 2 by 2 or 3 by 3, you can find. So if your A matrix, coefficient matrix is of 100 by 100 or 1000 by 1000, depending upon your practical problem, this system will arise. So if you have the large system, then you may not find the solution using your known methods. Okay? So there we need the numerical analysis or numerical methods. Similarly, I have, suppose, eigenvalue problem Ax is equal to lambda x. Fine? So this A again is large, okay, maybe 100 by 100. Then how to find the eigenvalue? At least one, maximum, largest or smallest. Okay? So this, that is why we need to have this course, because in engineering or in science advanced courses, we need to have complicated equations depending upon the practical problem that you are going to solve in your own course. So there we need to solve this type of equations, and we need to have the numerical methods and then the numerical analysis, so that I can have at least some results with respect to your practical problems. Understood? Now, next is, you have, suppose I have a problem, any problem from your chemical or metallurgy or computer science or any your practical problems, what is the procedure actually we will do? First one, you make a model. After making model, you do the mathematical model. Mathematical model means, depending upon your practical problems, your problem may be transferred to linear system equations or eigenvalue problems or differential equations or root finding. So that means whatever your practical problems are there, with respect to that, you will have some mathematical equations. Because it is a practical problem, you are not going to solve A plus B whole square. It depends. Suppose I want to design a car. Okay, there are many parameters, many loads. So depending upon that design of the car, I have to make the model. Model means mathematical model. Then I have to write that equation. Then after writing the equation, depending upon the problem, whether it is an eigenvalue problem or system of equations or differential equation, you have to choose the method that you want to apply. You will see that in each of these topics, you will have several methods. Why several methods? Because it depends upon the problem, depends upon the error that I will discuss after some time. So after mathematical model, what you will do? You will choose of the methods that you are going to apply depending upon your own problem. So after doing this, in general, by hand you cannot do or may not do, so you will write program by any programming environment. Okay? So after writing the program, you will execute that, and lastly you will validate. So what is the procedure? First you will have the mathematical model, then depending upon the problem you will have the choice of methods. If you have, suppose, differential equation, there are different methods depending upon the what type of differential equation is there. So you will choose the method, then you will apply that. For that means that algorithm you will write, then programming, then execute, then validate. Validate means after writing the program and executing, you need to know whether your program is correct or not. For that you have to validate for the known problem. Means for known problem you have to run that program. And if the result is matching approximately 2-3 problems, then you will think, okay, this may be the correct one. Then you use this program for the new problem. So in general, we follow this. So this is the main, our course is this choice of the method or the how the method works for different problems. So next, fixed point and floating point. So I hope this you know, fixed point and floating point arithmetic. So if I want to multiply 3.392345678 12 into 3 point into 300.91234512682. Okay, so if I want to multiply these two numbers, real numbers, what you will do? By hand, if you do, you have to keep track of all these decimals or not, but it is very cumbersome. Okay, see, if I have again a multiplication of maybe 100 digits, so you may not do on your notebook copy. Okay, so this actually fixed point means whatever decimal or numbers are there, you are taking all those numbers in your calculations. Okay, that is called fixed point. If but the fixed point you cannot use in your computer, because the computer is having limitation depending upon bits and bytes, whatever. Okay, maybe 16 digits or maybe 32 or 64 digits. Okay, it cannot go beyond that. Okay, that too depends upon the computer that you are using. So that is why in the computer we use this floating point. Okay, floating point we write this as plus minus sm b to the power k form. S designates plus minus plus minus, actually I have already taken s, so s is your sign, m is your mantissa, b is your base, k is your exponent. Base means if I am working on decimal system, so base may be 10. If I am working on maybe binary system, 2, similarly I can have 8, 16, depending upon that, but we will have decimal system, so this base is 10. So this is the form of floating point. I can write any number in this form. Okay? So if I have 10.234, I can write this in this form 0.10234 into 10 okay, fine. So see, this is your mantissa, here plus sign is there, plus okay, this is your base and this is your exponent. Okay, fine. So this can be taken by the computer. Again, here is a problem that we will discuss little bit after. So now again, you can think that this exponent, again it can go to 1000, it can go to 1 million, can it go? Again it depends upon the computer, okay? Because this exponent is having a limitation between computer to computer, okay? So here certain computer we have this exponent as minus 38 to 38 in single position. Sometimes it is minus 308 to 308. Means it can go this k or is equal to k or k, okay? This here I have written k. So minus 38 to 38 it can vary, or minus 308 to 308 it can vary in double precision. First one is the single precision, second one is the double precision. Fine. Now what do you mean by these limits? If it is less than this, if it is minus 39 or minus 40, then we get error in the program as underflow. Underflow. If I get more than this, suppose somewhere in the calculations it is more than 38, 40, you will get overflow as error. Sometimes you get, when you run the program, those who have written the program, you get overflow. Means it cannot handle that. You have to write the program accordingly, or you have to choose the method accordingly so that you will not get this type of error. Fine? So it depends again, if you go to supercomputer, maybe it will be, these limits will be more, means this width of this limit. Fine. So now let us come to the next thing, that is your algorithm. What do you understand by an algorithm? See, whatever we do, whatever we do, suppose I want to drive a bicycle or a car, we have the algorithm, okay? How to start, how to drive the car, how to stop. So you have certain means instructions. Again, if you want to suppose prepare a cake, again you have certain instructions, certain logic. How much flour, how much sweet means sugar you will give. So you should not give much sweet so that it will be very much sweet, so cake will be just so like that in algorithm, a computer also means in the these methods also we have the method. So for that you have to write the algorithm. So what is this? This is set of step by step instructions, logical instructions having a stopping criteria. That means I have to stop somewhere. If I am driving a car, I have to stop somewhere, otherwise will bump. Okay? So this is your algorithm. So whenever you write a program, you need to have the algorithm for the particular method. There you have to have some end and in between the steps. Okay? This is your algorithm. Then you have stability. What do you understand by stability? So you have read in physics about stability, stable and unstable. Okay? So if I have this funnel, so if I take like this, so this is stable or unstable? Unstable, because if I give, suppose it cannot stand on that in its edge. So if this other way around, so this is your stable, because up to certain limit, if you apply the force, it will not disturb from its original position. So from physics, you know this is stability. So same procedure in these methods or in numerical analysis. So if you have some method, okay, you give x input, you are getting y output. X is your input, y is your output. Okay? Any method, any problem you are doing, you are giving input, you are getting output. Now if I change this x by very small amount delta x, okay, I am changing, means like this, here the this is stable or unstable. If I give a little bit force, if it is not disturbing, so it is stable. If it is disturbing, that is unstable. So I am giving a little increment here, delta x. Okay? So if I get the change in the output as again a small amount delta y, understood? If I give a small increment here in the input, if I get the output as a small increment, then that method is stable. So if I give here x plus delta x and this is stable, and if I suppose I get 1000 delta y, means if I change here little bit the input and your change in the output is enormous, then that method is unstable. Understood? So that is why we have different types of method depending upon the problem or the area that you are doing. So there you have the stability, etc. Which method I should use? Fine? Okay, now normalized form. Means this is actually from the floating point arithmetic that we were discussing little bit ago. So normalized form, we write like this, plus minus 0.d1, d2, d3, dk into 10 to the power n. See, this is floating point. We have already discussed it was in terms of S m b to the power k. Okay? So, this is S sin, this is sin, this is your mantissa. This is your base. I have taken decimal system, so 10, and this n is your exponent. Fine. Now, this d1 to dk means any number that you have, I can write in this form so that it can go to the computer. So, now this d1 range, can you tell me what is the range of d1 and what is the range of dk should be? So, this range should be 1 to 9, means first digit should be 1 to 9, because 0 I cannot put. Suppose I take 0.0012. Okay? So, now I will write that. So, and this may be 0 to 9. Why? See, 0.0012, I am writing in the normalized form. So, what will be? This is plus 0.12 into 10 to the power minus 2. Okay? So, this is the sign. This is your mantissa. You see d1 here, only d1 and d2 is there. d1 and d2 is there. d1 is 1, d2 is 2. Fine? And d1 is 1, 1 to 9 it can have. So, I cannot put this 0, 0. Okay? And this is base and this is exponent. If I have 0.0000910, fine. So, I can have 0.910 into 10 to the power minus 4. So, you see now d1 is 9, depending upon whatever digit is there, but it cannot have 0 here. So, that is why range is from 1 to 9. In the last here d1, d2, d3, d3 I can have 0. Understood? So, this is the normalized form, because this normalized form usually will be used when you solve the problem. So, these are very essential and very important in the subsequent methods that you are going to solve or going to use or going to study the methods. Okay, fine? Now, from here, you have read already this also, that is chopping and rounding. I already told about this exponent, that this exponent limit depends upon the computer that you are using, otherwise you will get underflow or overflow. But I told that about this mantissa, there is also a limitation. You cannot have here 1000 digit in the mantissa. It cannot go inside the computer. You have to cut somewhere, or it will automatically cut. Okay? But in the exam, if I give this type of problem, suppose any problem, you cannot have 10 digit calculations. Okay? So, there also you have to cut somewhere. So, for cutting the digits, you have two types of procedure, that is chopping off and rounding off. Suppose after 3 digits I want to chop, that means for this up to d3 I will put, d1, d2, d3, rest I will ignore. But if I am ignoring, what is happening? If you are ignoring the other digits, that means you are having some error. See, if you have integer, or if you are doing that all the digits you are taking into consideration, no problem. But due to the computer or due to the limitation of your calculations, you need to have certain number of digits in your calculations. But if you truncate this somewhere by these two procedures, you are having some error. So, understanding for any digit that you are converting to this chopping or rounding, you are always have an error. Okay? So, if you have, you are cutting, suppose 3 digits, 0.1235. Okay? So, if I want to have 2 digit calculations, okay, fine. two-digit calculations. So, for two digits, I will take it as 0.12. Fine? So, if I take this number as 0.12, okay? So, 0.12 means two digits you are ignoring. That means this is having error or not. But here I am just cutting 0.12. It is two digit. If I take up to 3, what will get cutting? 1, 2, 3 up to here. So, if I just cutting, I am not seeing after that digit, what is that? So, it is called chopping. It is called chopping. So, these are all chopping. Now, if I have three-digit rounding, three-digit rounding from here, so what will get? 0.124. This is three-digit rounding. Understood? So, rounding is what? If I want to take up to three-digit, that means I have D1, D2, D3. So, I have to check the next digit, that means D4. Here, three-digit, 1, 2, 3, then I have 5. So, check the next digit. If it is 5 or more than 5, I have to add one unit here. That's why I have written 0.124, that is rounding. Okay? But if it is less than 5, so for two-digit, okay, two-digit rounding will be what? Again, 1, 2. So, you are seeing for two-digit rounding, for this number is same, because this 3 is less than equal to 5. Understood? So, that is why to start with the problem for your practical purpose or exam or whatever, you need to first decide how many digit work we will do, 3-digit, 4-digit or 2-digit, and what type of chopping I will do, rounding or chopping we will do, because you should not mix, somewhere it is chopping, somewhere rounding in the calculations. You fixed first how many digits you want to take, and then fixed I will do all rounding. Okay, fine. You take all rounding calculations, 3-digit rounding. If it is chopping, you take all chopping. But if it is given, maybe sometime it may be given 3-digit accuracy. So, at least you should take then 4-digit. And it is preferable to use rounding. Okay? So, it depends upon the problem, method, and what type of rounding and chopping you are using, how many decimal you are taking. Okay. So, from here, so see, what we are doing for one number, suppose this number, you are generating an error, because you are limiting to some digit. Okay? So, naturally, I have some error. So, that is why next is the error. Okay? So, for any problem, suppose I take that root finding, suppose P or some number, P is the exact value and P star it is approximated value. So, now because you know P exact means, suppose I consider this as exact, okay? This is your exact number given, and if I take 3D or 2D rounding, this is your approximated. So, there is an error. So, this error we define two way, that is absolute error that we write as EA, A for absolute, as absolute value of P minus P star. Means absolute value of true value minus approximated value, whatever you are getting, that is your absolute error. Absolute, why? We are not bothering about whether it is plus or minus. What is the deviation? Okay? That is why absolute value of P minus P star. So this way we find the absolute error. Similarly, I have relative error relative to that. So that is why ER P minus P star by absolute value of P, and this is your relative error. Fine. So in each calculations you have either absolute error, both the errors you have, whatever you need depending upon the problem or depending upon the question, sometimes relative error, find absolute error. So this we can find like this, P minus P star. So here comes one question that I told that numerical methods are used when you do not have the analytical solution. I already told that if you do not have the analytical solution, then we go to the numerical methods. That means I have here written P as the exact value. So suppose I have 100 degree polynomial, I want to find the root. So as per this error formula, you need to have the exact value. But in actual case, I do not have the exact value. So how do you find the error? Understood? Suppose I have the integration complicated function, I want to find the absolute error. Can you find that? Because I do not know the exact value of that integration. Approximate I can find by this method, whatever method we will study later. But that we know, P star we know, P we do not know. That is why this error we sometimes gives in terms of bounds. Again, this significant digit comes for the normal, from the normalized form that we have already discussed. Okay, so if I have a number 0.000123, how many significant digits? So the procedure is, again we will convert, we will write in terms of normalized form. So what we will get? 0.123 into 10 to the power minus 4. This is the normalized form. So we will see how many numbers are there in this. I have 3. So, 3 significant digits. Okay? So, after writing to the normalized form, I will see the mantissa. How many digits are there? Okay? So, if I have like this 0.0011012, how many significant digits? See, yes, here I will write 11012 into 10 to the power minus 2. You see, this 0 is significant. That is why I gave this example. This 0 is significant. Understood? But these zeros were not significant. So that is why I convert this to normalized form and see this. How many digits are there in that mantissa? Those are the significant digits. Okay? Because in the problems when you solve, again you have to see the significant digits, because you need to have the convergency, etc. That we will do maybe in the next class. Okay? So we will have methods, those are called iterative methods. First we will do iterative, before that we will do the about the sum error. Means why error? Because you saw already that for any number that is given, suppose it is a 10 digit number, you are calculating with 3 digit number. So we are creating an error. Okay? So in one number you are taking an error. So suppose I have like this 0.12345986. This is your actual number that you are getting from some experiment. Okay? Now another is 0.9234567. I want 3 digit calculations. Okay? Chopping suppose. So I will take 0.123. Understood? Here I will take 0.923. So here you go, you give one error, you one error, two errors. Now if I add, suppose addition is required in your calculations. If I add, so addition again, these are error already there, so again addition, there is another error. Multiply, error, subtraction, error. So you are seeing, means each and every calculations, you will have some, you are creating more and more error. That means error is propagated. Error is propagated. That's why it is very essential to use the efficient method. And efficient method is, again it is by practice and by intelligence that what is the problem and what method we will use so that we will get the less error. Less error. So that's why in each of these topics that I have written, I have maybe 5 to 6 methods, different methods. Depending upon which method gives less error, that you should use. Again, it is again problem dependent. You may not have one method that it is universal. Not only in numerical method, in any method that you are using, there are various methods of solving your problems. So that is why this error is very important in this course, that error will be propagated. So we will do two small theorems in the next class, that how these errors are propagated with respect to maybe addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. Okay? Then these calculations only you are doing in the computer. Whatever you are doing either addition, subtraction, multiplication or division. Fine? So with this, today we are stopping here. So next class, again, we will start with this error. Thank you very much.